Hey baby, say baby, it's your girl Yanni. I'm filming this on Sunday. It's 12 in the morning and I'm bored. So I was like, I'm gonna leave my hair. So I'm going to attempt to do some jumbo, either knotless or box braid, I don't know. Some jumbo box braids in my hair. And the supplies that I have are, sorry, y'all. Okay, y'all in a weird setup, so it's awkward. So, you know, beeswax like I do in every video. And then I have two wide tooth combs. This one hurts, so I don't really use it, but I might end up using it. That's why I bought it. I mean, that's why I got it with me right now. And then this one I'm gonna use to part my hair. And I got two rat tail combs. This one to also part my hair, just in case that I don't like the way this one parts, the pink one. And then this one to perfect the parts. And then my dimming brush and this brush. I don't know if I'm going to use all of this, but I have it. And then I also have my Eco Styler right here. The green kind. The olive oil one. I have this. And hair. This is old hair, but it's never been used. It's just leftover hair. So I have this one. And then this red one that I'm going to split into two. And put like in the front right there, probably, if I don't just do one braid. And then have two more of the black. So yeah, but what I'm gonna do before I even decide to start braiding, whatever, I'm gonna part my hair. I'm gonna part my whole entire head. I'm gonna pre-part it to make this process go faster because I'm not trying to be braiding all night. So yeah, I'm gonna speed that part up and you guys can just enjoy. Sections. As y'all can see, I was struggling, but I got it as straight as possible. I ain't trying no more, I'm done. But what I'm gonna do now is part this back section, like, you know, all the way up or whatever. And I'll come back when my whole head is pre-parted, because I don't want this video to be too long because it's not a tutorial, so it's like, I don't have to film everything. But I'll come back when I got my whole head parted. So yeah. So it is now 4 a.m. and I am done with the back of my head. Just the back of my head. The parts is nowhere close to nice. I already know that. I couldn't spend 35 minutes on one part. So I just parted. I'm gonna show y'all the back of my head. So yeah. But I'm finna show y'all how I do one of the braids, because it was very much trial and error. So I got this braid right here, and I'm gonna show y'all how I do it. So I have sectioned out all the hair already. I'm not gonna show y'all because my room is a mess, sadly. But what I do is I take a small piece off. So what I did was I sectioned all the braids with the size that I wanted. And then I just break this into multiple pieces to create the braid. So I do one small piece for the first piece, and then the last part that I have, I just break it in half for the second and third pieces that I add on, like so. So then, y'all, this lighting is horrible. I'm already knowing, but it's the best I can do right now until I get a good old ring light. But I take the beeswax and I put it on the root only, because this stuff is out strong and I don't really want it all over my hair. So I put it on the root. And another reason why I didn't care about my parts is because this is just a quick hairstyle. Like, I don't even think I'm gonna keep this hairstyle until Christmas. Christmas is in like a week and a half. I think I'm just gonna keep it for like a week. And then I'll brush it, brush all of it so it's not white no more. And my ends, you see how my ends are so curly? They didn't blend well because I don't have nothing to make them like smooth, because the Eco Styler doesn't do anything like I thought it would. So next time I'll just get edge control next time I decide to do this hairstyle. But you take three pieces of your hair. People say they need to be even, but I don't care. So I just take three pieces and I braid it three or four times. I've been doing three mostly. But yeah, do that, one, two, and then three. And then right here in between these two fingers, I put the hair right there, and then I put it on top with that piece, and then I braid it three more times. So one, two, four more times. Then I get the second piece of hair and put it in the same spot I put the first piece of hair, but I have my last piece of my hair sticking out. And then I just braid it a few times until it gets closer to the end of my natural hair. You see how this piece is the thickest piece? I make sure I don't add no more hair in that piece. So these two pieces are the thinnest pieces, so that's when I'm gonna add the next piece of hair, the last piece of hair. I only put 3 pieces of hair in each braid. So, yeah. But see my ends, how curly they are? And I was trying to do the tucking method, but I just wasn't getting it. So I just started braiding it. It's okay. These aren't gonna be in my head that long, so it don't even matter. But next time I'm gonna be more prepared because I'm gonna have all the necessities to do my hair. If I'm talking low, it's because, like I said, it's 4 in the morning and my family is asleep, so I can't really be loud because our walls are really thin. So it's really tight. I don't know if this stuff gonna crust over, but it might, but I don't care. So yeah, so I'm gonna show y'all two more times with these two braids, and then I'll just come back when I finish my head, because I'm watching YouTube and stuff and it's making it go by faster a little bit. But yeah, it's not difficult. I just couldn't get the grip right when I first tried to do these braids. I just couldn't get the grip right, but now that I got it right, it's so much easier to do it. I can do it on other people. I just couldn't do it on myself, but now I can do it on myself. So I think next time I'm gonna do smaller braids, but we'll see. So just braid it all the way to the end. And I'm gonna dip them in the morning. So when I finish my head, I'm gonna tie a scarf around it and put my bonnet on, go to bed. And in the morning, I'm gonna dip it. And then I'll show y'all the end result. And I'm probably gonna put clips in there at the end of this video. If I decide to take little Snapchat videos or whatever. So yeah. So this video is going up on Monday at 12 p.m. Do y'all want to watch me clean my room? Like, comment that on this video, and that'll be the next video on Wednesday. So do y'all want me to, like, record cleaning my room? But if I do, y'all can't judge me. I'm stressed, and it shows in my room. I am going through it, and it shows in my room very much so. So do you guys want that type of video, a clean with me video? Let me know. Or do y'all want a sit down video where I talk to y'all about stuff? Or you can give me ideas to tell a story. I haven't done much, so try to like give me a few ideas. But yeah, and don't say first fight, because I ain't never been in a fight before. So let me know. Braid all the way down to the end. So I'll be back when I do these two videos. Do these two braids. Okay. These are the next two braids. This one and this one. I'm actually going to fix the part on these because this doesn't make no sense. It's not even enough to look nice. Y'all, I'm tired. I thought this was going to take like 2 hours, but I've been doing this since 12 in the morning. And I think it's because I had to go through and part my hair like that. I should have did that yesterday like I was planning on doing it, but how was that? I went to my boyfriend's house the other day. Yesterday, because I'm not thinking about what day it was. I went to my boyfriend's house on Friday, and I wanted to do this video Saturday, but I was tired, and I just wasn't going for it. But yeah, so I'm gonna fix this part. Okay, that's better. That's a tad bit better. It didn't do much, but it looked more better than before. It looks better than before. Okay. So again, I'll take a little piece. For the first piece. Oh, and this is pre-stretched hair. I think it's easier to do these braids with pre-stretched hair. So you don't have to go through and do all of that work. It makes the process a little bit easier. Let me twist this section. Even though I thought I already did. Okay. And then grab my beeswax. I'm trying to make this last because it's almost gone finally. There's a mirror right here, as y'all probably know. Put the beeswax on. I really wish I had edge control instead, because I hate beeswax. I don't like putting it in my hair. But that's all I got, and that's all that's strong enough right now for this style. If I was doing regular box braids, I would have just did Eco Styler, but I'm not. And Eco Styler does not lay my hair down good enough for knotless. Put this into three. And then again, braid it three times. One, two, three. Then you get your hair, put it in between these two fingers, like that. And then put that up there with that hair and continue braiding like normal four times. One, two, three, four. So that this is back on the outside. And then you get your second piece of hair, put it in between your index and middle finger again, like that. Continue braiding. Break down a few times though. Until you're ready to add more hair. Now with this one, this middle piece is the thickest piece. So I'm gonna wait till this gets into the middle and this gets on the outside. So like that. So now the two thinnest pieces are on the outside. And I'm gonna add my third piece. And then just braid all the way down like normal. Now this braid is kind of small compared to the rest. I wanted these to be a little bit bigger, but I didn't have the hair for that. And it doesn't really bother me how small it is. Even though I would like all my braids to be the same size, but they're not, so it is what it is. And it's in the front, so it kind of makes sense to me for some reason. Like, it makes sense for it to get smaller in the front. Whew, I can't breathe, y'all. We got finals next week. But I'm still going to upload for y'all. I'm going to still film videos and upload and be more consistent. Cause I just, I looked at my last video and it did so bad compared to every other video. It got like 7 views, I think. Yeah, somewhere around there. It's so low. It's worse than like my intro video, cause that was bad first. But I'm gonna be more consistent. And I'm actually gonna like try with my thumbnails, because I did not try with that thumbnail. I just screenshotted a part of the video and put the caption over it. I'm gonna actually, like this thumbnail, I'm probably gonna do something like cute with it. I'm gonna figure it out. So yeah, I'm gonna be more consistent. And I'm getting a laptop on Christmas, so it'll be easier to upload and stuff. I'll just have to figure it out because it's not a MacBook or nothing like that. It's an HP laptop. I'll just have to figure it out how to transfer my videos from my iPhone to the laptop. And then it'll be easier to edit because it's hard to edit on my phone. So yeah. But I think I'm going to do an update video. Even though y'all probably don't care for real. I just want to do one. Cause like honestly, I'm doing these videos for myself to give me something to do, because I don't do anything all day. I just sit in my room and watch people play Sims all day. I have no life. The only time I ever do something is when I go anywhere with my boyfriend, or like me and my sister will go somewhere with one of our cousins. But that's about it. So I was like, I want to start a YouTube channel. So I'm just gonna talk to y'all about why I started a YouTube channel, like get in depth with it, and just talk to y'all about where I want this channel to go and stuff like that. I'm gonna update y'all on the type of videos that I'm gonna make, because in my first video it didn't make sense on what type of videos I wanted to make, because I wasn't sure yet. But now I'm sure, so I'm gonna let y'all know. And I'm rocking like this because my back hurts, I'm sorry, but I'll let y'all know, excuse me and whatnot. Because I kind of started this channel like randomly. But I'm going to just say that for that video. I think that's the type of video I'm going to do next. After this, after I upload this one, I'm going to film that one. Not tonight, but when this one goes up, I'm going to film that one. Probably like Tuesday after school or something. Because I get out early on Tuesdays. So yeah. I will come back to y'all when my whole head is finished. So, if you want to see the end results, stay tuned, because I hope it's going to be cute. So, I'll be right back. So, it's the next day. As y'all can see, the sun is out. And I finally finished the braids. I'll show y'all. Excuse the dog, she's outside right now. So I finally finished the braids. And now I'm gonna dip them in hot water. So I got my towel in this cup in our water machine, because I'm not gonna boil the water. I got this towel to hold the cup. So what I'm gonna do is fold my towel in half and put it right here. So I don't burn myself. I'm gonna get this one. I guess I didn't need this time. I just dip my hair in there. And the reason I did this is to make it not be so stiff and to seal it. because I don't burn the ends of my hair, so I need to do that to seal it and to loosen the hair. Same to this side. I didn't think I was gonna like it, but this is kind of cute. So slight, just for like a few weeks, whatever, whatever. This is really cute. But I'm still gonna insert clips at the end of this video. But thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Share this video with your people. And stay tuned for the next video. Bye. I can make you fall in love with this. Ooh, you wouldn't know what to do. You look at me like